Right, Richard, it's Joe from Average Joe's Joinery here. I'm really enjoying your cutting edge router series. I'm learning so much. I've got a question for you. My router luckily can take both half inch and quarter inch shanks, but what's the difference really? When would I need to use a half inch shank compared to a quarter inch shank, and vice versa? Is it just literally the harder the wood, the thicker the shank you go for, or is there more to it? Thanks.
Really good question, Joe. To be honest, it really hasn't got that much to do with the material that you're working, so the hardness of the wood doesn't really come into it, and I'll explain why in just a second. Fundamentally, the difference between quarter, 8mm, 3/8, 12mm, half inch, blah, 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 shank diameters, is the bigger the diameter, the bigger the cutting head you can put on the end of it. So, you know, take the old cheapo, and this is cheap, panel raising bit. There's a lot of mass on there. And when you are machining something, you're putting force against that. So that chunky bit of shank, the bigger it is, the chunkier it is, the more it can resist that sideways push that you're putting on it. Yeah, so you get less deflection. Because of that, you'll find that manufacturers will limit the size of cutter they'll put on the smaller shanks. So take a quarter inch shank, you won't be able to buy a panel raising bit or a 2 inch diameter tenon cutter or something like that. But conversely, you can still have a small diameter cutter, in this case 5mm diameter cutter, on a half inch shank. Quarter inch shanked bits will have a range of diameter cutters, usually up to about an inch ish somewhere around there. Now certainly here in the UK, cutters with an 8mm shank are becoming more and more available, and that allows, because you've got that slightly wider shank, you can have a wider cutter. If you've got a half inch router, now there's no reason why you can't buy half inch shanked small bits. That's perfectly acceptable. So in that sense, you've got a wider range of cutters that you can choose from. But you've got to balance that with the machine and the application you're doing. So for example, if you wanted to hang a door in your house, and then you want to machine the mortises in the door lining on a big half inch router that weighs sort of 6 kilos, you wouldn't want to be doing that all day long above your head, putting that top hinge mortise in. You'd want a smaller router. So again, smaller router, smaller cutter. So it's kind of the application you're working. It really boils down to depth of cut in terms of the limitations. Now, just because you've got a big half inch shanked bit doesn't mean, say, you can hog out loads of material. And there's quite a misconception with this, because nobody really, and I've looked both on YouTube and websites and all the rest of it, there isn't really a definitive guide to depth of cut. People they seem to be reluctant to commit themselves. So I hope, this is where this video will differ. It boils down to experience, admittedly, but as a rule of thumb, your depth of cut will be limited to the shank diameter of your cutter, the diameter of the actual cutting head, and you won't want to plunge or take cuts deeper than whichever of those two is smaller. So for example, if we take a 10mm cutter and we put it on a quarter inch shank, if we're routing a trench, so that shape, we won't cut deeper than the shank diameter, so 6mm. We then put that cutter on a half inch shank in a big machine, a big powerful machine, the temptation is to drop it and go. But the weakest point of your cutter is going to be the narrowest point. Yeah? So in this case, 10 mil. So our depth of cut now increases from 6 mil as a quarter inch shank to 10 mil, which is the diameter of the cutter. Yeah? I say it boils down to a bit of experience. You know, that's a rule of thumb, a guide, if you will. Now, if you're hogging out a really hard material like maple, walnut, even beech or something like that, you'll take a little less of a cut because it's a hard material, it's working the cutter hard, it's resisting the cutter, it's working the motor harder, etc. etc. If you're trying to hog out something like balsa wood, which is really soft, then you probably go deeper. So it's that. And in those circumstances, it's when your ears come into play. You'll hear the motor start to struggle, perhaps. You'll feel the machine resist you. So listen and feel, and you won't go too far wrong. But certainly start with that cutter slash shank diameter guy. That's where you start with the trenches. If you're trimming an edge, then you can drop down. I hope that answers your question without making it even more mysterious. If you've got any other questions, or if you want any clarification on this, then leave a comment, get in touch, and I'll try and sort things out. Likewise, if you're watching this and you liked it, thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, because fingers crossed, we've got some fantastic guests lined up with some hopefully challenging questions. And we'll see you next time. Don't forget to like and subscribe.